I'm Dave.
I'm Craig.
And this is the Wizard Product Review on this week's show. Right, first up, Craig, it's The Key.
The Key by Andrew Main.
By Andrew Main. You get a little package inside there as well with the necessary equipment to perform this effect. It's not just a DVD.
I've got to be honest, I had low expectations coming into this. Andrew Main brings out so many products on such a regular basis, and the quality, I'll be honest, the quality from my point of view have been going downhill and downhill and downhill. A lot of his earlier stuff, very, very good. A lot of his
Trick Ghost Vision.
Oh, did you?
I didn't like it. I didn't like it.
And then he's bringing a lot of illusions and things out that just don't... I didn't think this was going to be very good.
Didn't think it was going to be very good, but actually...
It's excellent.
It is very, very good. And the basic effect is kind of like Timothy Wenk's
Misled.
Yeah. I hope I said his name right. And on Copperfield's show many years ago, he really popularized this, didn't he? With the bill sort of being penetrated by the pencil. It's that effect, but it's a little bit more organic.
And there's so many versions that have come out since then. Jay Sankey brought out Doe, and you've got the, you know, the classic pen through notes, through banknote. But I genuinely think that this is the best version, and definitely the more organic, the most organic version I've ever seen of penetrating a banknote.
The best version of penetrating a banknote.
I can't
ever.
Think of a better way of doing it.
It is very, very clean. It's exactly the same effect. And the nice thing about it is, if you want to perform this effect, there's really no surprises, is there? When you get the product, you open it up. The DVD is quite basic.
It's him to camera. But he explains it well. And one thing that I know that we both remarked on, when you're watching him perform, it's obvious he's worked it in. There's a lot of tricks on there, a lot of tips that you think, okay, this guy's worked this in. This isn't something that he's just thought of and decided to market. He has actually worked this in.
Yeah, he's not just produced it and said, hey, I can make some money here. You believe that he's had this effect and on his key ring for the last couple of years. He's been out there in the trenches, he's worked it, and he does it very, very well with the teaching that you get. I don't think it'd be long before you'd be doing it as well.
It's really easy. It's examinable beforehand, it's examinable at the end. You put it on your key fob, you're ready to go. And there's a couple of nice bonus routines on there. There was the key through card.
The pen through card. You don't actually fold the card with that, but it's a very nice version.
I thought that was great.
With the card. He did a sort of knife through coat routine.
That's when it went downhill.
I didn't like that. It's a bonus idea anyway. We didn't like that because you kind of get lost where the hole's meant to be in the coat. And
I wasn't too keen on the bitten key either. I didn't like that.
But you can do these extra effects with everything that you get from the key. The effect of the key going through the note is worth the purchase alone. We both said we're going to do it.
We're going to go. I'm going to do it. Yeah,
we're going to perform this effect. It's very good. I'm going to give this 89%.
I'm going to give it 89% as well. I'm copying you.
Hi, this is Titanus, the creator of Titan's Finger, and I hopelessly... Wait, desperately, no, that's not good either. I feverishly want to be on the Wizard Product Review. Did I say want? I meant to say I need to. In fact, you know what? If I don't make the next episode, I'll fly over and break your little...
Thank you very much, Titanus. Maybe we could review something of Titanus.
I think we get the hint, don't we?
We could review something of his in the future.
Yeah, definitely.
Also, we had a competition last week.
To win a consignment.
It was involving the discussion area of our Facebook page. And we asked people to post comments about the show, ask us to review things. And Stephen Mayers was somebody that got in touch and asked us to review the key.
Which, job done. There you go.
We've done that for you, Stephen. You were the first to post in our discussion area. And he's got a consignment winging his way to him right now.
Hope you enjoyed, Steve.
Well, not right now. You've got to get in touch with the show. Perhaps even post on Facebook.
Yeah, that's a good idea.
Right, next up, Puzzle Paradox.
Puzzle Paradox. What a big box.
It's a big box, bigger than the other things we normally get sent. World Magic Store have got this on offer at the moment. It's a very good price.
Ridiculously cheap.
You need to go to worldmagicstore.com and look at the offers section, which is the tab.
And on there, there's a full performance of you actually performing the routine for me as well. So they can
and it's not stooged.
No, not at all. The first time I actually saw it was when Dave performed it to me. He said, hey, come and have a look at this, and we caught it on camera.
So, It's not stooged. The performance is exactly as you see it is. You've basically got your prediction, which is a jigsaw puzzle covered up with one piece missing, although the audience doesn't know that at the time. They then choose one jigsaw puzzle piece out of 150 pieces. It's very, very fair indeed. Better than other methods at this stage that are on the market. I used to perform the Mona Lisa effect
all the time. Yeah.
And the Mona Lisa has got certain advantages over Puzzle Paradox.
Right.
The size of the pieces is better for stage.
Okay.
That's what I didn't like about this. I think it's only suitable for parlor or smaller cabarets. If you haven't got video projection on stage, I think the negative is, and the only negative with the whole thing, is the puzzle pieces are a bit smaller.
Right. I mean, you showed it me.
Yeah.
And you fooled me completely. I had no idea how it worked. And as you know, I got one there and then.
Yeah.
And the weekend just gone, I've put it into my kid show. I had a kid show for older children.
Right.
Sort of that difficult 8, 9, 10, 11-year-old age.
Yeah.
And I put it in there, and it just went great. You know, it's not an issue for 40 or 50 kids having those size puzzle pieces.
Right. Okay.
And it went into the show straight away, and I think it's very, very good. It's really good. You can present it very quickly, or you can take your time over it. There's lots of different options, and it really is a fool.
And the choice... It's so free, the choice. You can point out that the other pieces are completely different, and yet when you take off that cover at the end and it matches.
It's a great moment because everybody, you kind of know what's coming, and you're like, no way, that can't be right. And then when they reach forward and they put the puzzle in, the actual piece in, and it fits, it's like, that's really good.
And you can have a puzzle piece chosen and then do some other mentalism style effects.
Yeah.
And then at the end of it, at the end of doing a couple more effects, you know, say now put the final piece of the puzzle in place, reveal it.
Yeah.
I'm guessing that you are going to give this a good review because you were amazed by it.
Yeah, I was fooled by it. I've actually put it in my show. Yeah, I'm going to give it 88%. I think it's very good, and I think it's the sort of thing you can perform in a lot of different situations. It's great for adults, great for kids, great for family shows. I think that it's a really good piece.
I think if it was as expensive as it used to be, my mark wouldn't be as good, but the fact that it's such a good price at the moment as well for such a quality piece of magic, I'm going to give this 86%. Right, our final review this week is Time is Money.
What an awesome routine.
This just screams quality, doesn't it?
Look at the box it comes
in. You get a box as well. Look at this. This really is impressive.
It really is.
It's great quality, but quality comes at a price, doesn't it?
It's not cheap. Well, we've had a lot of people come on the show and they've said they want us to review more stage items. So we tried to do that with this and with Puzzle Paradox. And the problem with stage items, they're a lot more money. And although World Magic Store have got this on a really good price at the moment, it's still a big chunk of change. You know, it's not cheap.
The effect, let's talk about the effect briefly. It's kind of like a bank night style routine. You borrow a bill, tear the corner off, you can have the bill signed as well, put into an envelope, mix with other envelopes. Lovely moment where the three other envelopes are strimmed. That's the only thing you don't get with it, actually. Everything else you get, but you can easily buy a battery-operated strimmer.
Yeah.
And then, at the moment that you open up the last envelope, they're expecting the bill to be in there. Nothing of value is in there. I think he has his shopping list.
He has his shopping list in there.
Which is funny. That moment, the time runs out.
And there's a spectator holding that thing.
Holding it all the way through, kind of in this position. And at the moment the sand runs out, it reveals the bill in there. The bill is taken out of the hourglass.
And the routine is so well structured. That what I liked about the DVD is they had five or six magicians performing the same routine.
Yeah.
So you saw different ways of doing it. You know, so one guy did it as a full patter routine. My favourite presentation, I think yours as well,
the
one with the music.
Yeah.
And Mission Impossible. And you get the music track with it.
You get the music, you get the DVD, you get extra sand. to make even more time if you want to. It really is the complete package.
You and I have been out performing this for a couple of weeks now, and we've both done it. We've actually worked it, and we've put an ebook together, haven't we, of additional ideas, like several other ideas, including a way of actually getting the bill signed, so it's a signed bill that appears inside there. And you know, I wouldn't have gone to that much effort if I didn't think it was something that I wanted to work in. I'm really enjoying performing
it. It's a fantastic effect.
Yeah.
It's a reputation maker. The only negative thing is the price.
It's just ridiculously expensive.
It is expensive. If you want something of quality, you want something unique, you can go for it, but it's not cheap, even though World Magic Store do have it at a good price. Mm. I'm going to give this 86%.
I give it a higher mark, but based on the price, I can't give it more than 80%. You know, it's a great thing, but 80% is all it gets with the price.
Fair enough. That's it this week for the Wizard Product Review. Don't forget to check us out on YouTube, on Facebook, and don't forget, we're on iTunes. See you next week.